put on your mask, wash your hands, and certainly stay at home. These words are going to stick with us for a long time to come. Hi friends, Don and Robin Immel here. You know, we're at Christian Life Assembly in Camp Hill. We were here about a year ago, worshiping together and enjoying Ministry Summit. But oh my, things have changed in the last year, really in the last month.
That's right. Thanks for joining us and welcome to Refresh. You know, in Isaiah, he prophesied, "For with stammering lips and another tongue, he will speak to his people, to whom he said, 'This is the rest with which you may cause the weary to rest, and this is the refreshing.'" That's in Isaiah 28, 11 and 12.
The Apostle Peter took that passage in Acts chapter 3, and he used it when he was speaking with the Jewish folk at Solomon's portico. And he said, "Repent, be converted, every one of you." And the text rolls out so that the times of refreshing can come from the presence of the Lord. And that's what we're here for tonight.
So no matter where you are during this COVID-19 pandemic, there are extremes, aren't there? Some of us are home alone, and that can be very daunting. On the other end of the spectrum, there are families who are home with children 24/7, parenting, working from home, and homeschooling. So wherever you are on that spectrum, tonight, just take some time to be refreshed.
Yeah, so tonight we're going to take off our mask, let down our guard, and to a limited extent, skip the social distancing for a little while. Tonight's not that. For weeks we've been told to keep our distance, but tonight we're going to get close. We're going to engage, and I really hope that we get to relax and enjoy the Lord's presence, a time of refreshing. Join us for a moment, would you? Let's open our time up with some prayer. Father, we thank you so much for your goodness to us. We thank you for calling us into ministry and giving us the privilege of sharing the hope and the love and the comfort and the peace and the strength that we find in Jesus. But Lord, you know, some of us are kind of spent. Even though we've been sheltered in at home and our travel has been limited, and you'd think that from all of that, we just have a bundle of energy. But I sense that it's different for a lot of our folks. And so tonight, dear Lord, across the miles, across the states of Pennsylvania and Delaware, would you please visit us in our living rooms or our kitchens or our cars or our studies or wherever we might be out on the back patio. And I pray that would you please touch us with your Holy Spirit right now. Refresh us. Lord, we're hungry. We're thirsty. We want some of you here tonight. We want all that you have for us. So touch us. Refresh us. We pray in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, amen. Join us for a time of worship. Josh?
Come on, we're believing that what the enemy has meant for evil tonight, that he's gonna turn it for our good, amen? So we're gonna sing this song, "I See a Victory." We're gonna see a victory because we know that the battle belongs to our Lord, amen? Amen, come on, so sing this with us today. Come on, the weapon formed. The weapon may be formed, but it won't prosper. And when the darkness falls, it won't prevail. Come on. 'Cause the God I serve knows only how to triumph. No, my God will never fail. Come on, do you believe that today? No, my God will never fail. Come on, sing it. And I'm gonna see a victory. Oh, I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. And I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. Oh. Yes, Lord, we believe there's power in your name. Oh. Come on, sing it with us. There's power. There's power in the mighty name of Jesus. And every war he wages, he will win. No, I'm not backing down from any giant. Come on, we believe that I know how this story ends. Come on, let that be your faith tonight. Oh, I know how this story ends. Come on. And I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. And I'm gonna see a victory, I know. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. Come on, sing that. And I'm gonna see a victory. Oh, I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. And I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. We believe it belongs to you, God. You're raising faith tonight. You're refreshing us, God. Your spirit is moving in our living rooms. Your spirit is working in our hearts, God. We believe that today. We believe that today. Come on, he's working for our good. Sing that, church. That you take what the enemy meant for evil and you turn it for good. You turn it for good. Come on, that's what he's doing in your life tonight. That you take what the enemy meant for evil and you turn it for good. Yeah, you turn it for good. Come on, declare it in faith. I know, hey, that you take what the enemy meant for evil when you turn it for good. You turn it for good. You take, 'cause you take what the enemy meant for evil when you turn it for good. Yeah, you turn it for good. Come on, declare it. You take, 'cause you take what the enemy meant for evil when you turn it for good. You turn it for good. You take, 'cause you take what the enemy meant for evil when you turn it for good. Oh, you turn it for good. And I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. And I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. Come on, sing that. That I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. I'm gonna see a victory. I'm gonna see a victory. For the battle belongs to you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. We thank you, Lord. God, how we love you, how good you are to us. You're faithful, you never change. God, through every trial, through every storm, we can tell of your goodness, we can sing of your greatness today. Come on, sing it.
I love you, Lord. Oh, your mercy never fails me. And all my days, I've been held in your hands. From the moment that I wake, bigger until I lay my head. Oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I love your voice. Oh, oh, Jesus.
Come on, sing that.
I love your voice. You have led me through the fire. In the darkest night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father. I've known you as a friend.
Oh, I have lived in the goodness of God. Come on, sing, he's been faithful.
And all my life you have been faithful. Oh,
and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, I will sing of the goodness of God. Come on, sing his goodness. It's running after.
Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. I give you everything.
Your goodness is running after.
It's running after me.
Come on, sing at his goodness.
Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me. With my life laid down, I'm surrendered now. I give you everything. Your goodness is running after. It's running after me.
I'll sing it all my life.
And all my life you have been faithful. And all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. I will sing of the goodness of God. Oh.
We sing of your goodness. We tell of your goodness tonight. Come on, could you just express that in your living room, in your kitchen, wherever you are tonight? God, you are good. You are faithful. I praise you because you're worthy of praise, God. No one compares to you.
No one like you.
There's no one like you, Lord. Your goodness, your faithfulness, your mercies, God, I don't deserve. But you're still faithful, God. When I don't understand, you're still faithful, God. I worship you. You're worthy of my praise, God. You're worthy of my praise, Lord. Well, can we just sing this old chorus together? We sing of the praises to your name. We love you, Lord. And I sing praises to your name. Oh, Lord, praises to your name. Oh, Lord, for your name is great and greatly to be praised. Come on, sing it with me. I sing, and I sing praises to your name. And oh Lord, oh praises to your name. Oh Lord, oh for your name is great. Come on. and greatly to be praised. I give glory and I give glory to your name. Oh Lord, oh glory to your name. Oh Lord, for he's great, oh for your name is great. Thank you Lord. And greatly to be praised. We adore, we give you praise, and I give glory to your name. Oh Lord, glory to your name. Oh Lord, for your name is great. And greatly to be praised. For your name is great. Come on, he's great. And greatly to be praised. We give praise, Lord. And for your name is great. And greatly to be praised. So God, tonight we do. We give you all glory. We give you all praise because you're so deserving, God. God, there is no one like you. Even in the midst of trials, even in the midst of struggles, God, we know that you're there. We know that you're still faithful. God, even when we can't see it, when we don't understand, you're still working. You're still in control. So God, help us tonight just to feel that together. God, that in the presence of God, we would know that you're refreshing us. In the presence of God, that we would feel that manifest presence of your Spirit no matter where we are tonight. Spirit, move in power, move in might among your people over these airwaves today. We believe it and we agree together in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen and amen. Amen. Thanks again for worshiping with us tonight.
Josh, wow, I am feeling the start of being refreshed. So that's what we're talking about tonight, refresh. And Robin, what have you been doing to get refreshed? What does that look like for you?
Yeah, oh man. What have I been doing? Well, my refreshing has been a journey. Let me set the stage for you and share my story. Back in February, we were in Mexico with the Assembly of God World Missions team. And our friends Greg and Sandy Mundus and the whole World Missions team was there. Fast forward then into the beginning of March, when we as a nation were introduced to the COVID-19. And our friend Greg and Sandy, they were both hospitalized with the COVID, as well as other of the folks from the World Missions. So we watched daily as Greg's journey took him to the ventilator and very serious hospital days. While that was going on, I was watching the news.
A lot.
I wanted to be informed. So I did watch the news a lot, and I wanted to be balanced, so I watched CNN and Fox all the time. And I watched New York City be overtaken with corona. I was not in a good place. Do you remember that?
I noticed that.
Yeah, I was gripped with fear. Mm-hmm. I was convinced that we were going to both die alone on a ventilator.
Well, they were kind of implying that.
Everyone.
Yeah.
So, and then we had to isolate.
Sure.
You take an extrovert who loves to be with people, mm-hmm. and I was by myself, and that was not good. I withdrew from people, but I also found myself withdrawing from the Lord, and I was beginning to slip into depression. Mm. That was a couple of weeks that it was tough, and I am not proud of that. And I am so glad that the Lord met me there. He was faithful. And he brought me away from that. He used some lifelines. And let me just share a couple of them with you. One was Liz Dufresne's Mondays with Liz. It just kind of started to crack open my heart. And the Lord just began to refresh. One of the lifelines he used was a jar of blessing. Liz suggested this, and it helped me learn gratitude in the midst of this crazy pandemic. So each day of the coronavirus, I find something I'm joyful about or thankful for, and I put it in here, and it's just helped my heart turn to gratitude. Another lifeline was God's Word. It became life. With the Chasing Truth that many of us in the Assembly of God Women's group we're doing together, the Bible reading plan, but also digging deeper. And you know, God has a table, a feast every day, and that's His Word. And that menu's different every day because the Lord knows what I need for that day, and He feeds me from His Word. And that has just brought me so far. And last, another lifeline is prayer. Prayer grants me access to the Holy Spirit, and that brings such comfort. Refreshing came, and the fear was replaced. And He has your refreshing. He can replenish you physically, moms who are exhausted. He can replenish our mental health, our emotions. I was a lot of emotions. And He met me and He refreshed, emotionally and spiritually renewed. So.
You know, a little while ago, you read from Isaiah 28:12, but I had you stop one phrase from the end of the actual verse. So why don't you read that verse again, and but read it the whole way to the end.
All right, Isaiah 28:12. For with stammering lips and another tongue, He will speak to the people, to whom He said, this is the rest with which you may cause the weary to rest, and this is the refreshing, but you would not.
Listen to that phrase at the very end, but you would not. Doesn't that speak to all of us at times under certain circumstances? It's so easy to slip just through inattention or through being overrun by the news. It's so easy to slip into the doldrums or into a spiritual funk. And Isaiah, as well as Peter in his sermon, imply that to be refreshed, there's a choice involved in that. And so we can choose to sit on the couch and do nothing. And one of the negatives of sheltering in is disconnection. It's disconnection from relationships, disconnection from the strength that we find in the body of Christ. And we can slip into disconnection from the Word and the Spirit and prayer and those kinds of things. I'm wired to be busy. I like to be busy. And when I'm not busy, I sleep. But I'm really most comfortable with doing. And so this verse in Isaiah 28 really T-bones me. It just impacts me. That phrase, but you would not.
It T-bones you. That's good. That's very descriptive.
Yeah.
Well, let me ask you, what do you do to refresh?
So, you know, when this thing got rolling, this COVID thing and sheltering in and disconnectedness, I did what most guys do. I went on eBay. I ordered a bunch of albums. Yeah. I had gotten a record player for my stereo, and I ordered a bunch of albums, and these albums you know, they're vinyl round discs with grooves in them. These albums took me back to my spiritual formation days when I was a teenager and I came to Christ. Shortly thereafter, the Praise albums were just rolling out and becoming popular. They became so popular, there was Praise 1, Praise 2, Praise 28, I don't know how many. There were a bunch of Praise albums. So I went back, I jumped on eBay, I got a half a dozen of these Praise albums.
More, they come one at a time every day.
Listen, I don't tell your secrets, don't tell mine. But it refreshed my soul. Yeah. So I went down to the man cave, and it's cool down there, and I shut off the lights, and I turn on the Praise albums, and I get under a blanket, and I get refreshed. And not only did I hit the rewind button that way, I also jumped on Amazon Music, and I updated my worship playlist, and there were some really cool discoveries. I just Googled top 20 worship songs, and I found three or four or five that I added to my playlist. Worship really refreshes my spirit. Just worship, meditation, praise, prayer, that whole that all folds together into a very refreshing experience for me. So both Isaiah and Peter take refresh to a whole new level, being refreshed by the Holy Spirit in our inner spirit, and they encourage us to pray in the Spirit, and this is the refreshing. And we're going to keep being refreshed as we segue back into a time of worship. Josh?
I count on one thing, the same God that never fails
will not fail me now. You won't fail me now.
In the waiting, the same God who's never late
is working all things out. You're working all things out.
Yes, I will lift you high in the lowest valley. Yes, I will bless your name.
Oh,
Yes, I will. Yes, I will. Yes, I will. You know, that's a good phrase for making choices and choosing to refresh. And, you know, part of our refresh experience tonight is we want to refresh others, too. And we can do that with our prayer, our prayers. And so Jeff, our secretary treasurer slash network missions director, is going to lead us in a time of prayer and intercession for our missionaries.
Thank you so much, Pastor Don. Our missionaries around the world have been going through some interesting circumstances and situations. And today we want to offer prayer to them. You know, prayer changes things. Right. We believe in it. We believe the power of prayer, and we're believing for God to intervene in a supernatural way and for the power of the Holy Spirit to move into these missionaries' lives. And at the bottom of the screen, as we pray, you'll see the missionaries' names, you'll see the regions that they're in. And wherever you are in your home, I want to encourage you to pray for these missionaries. As their names come up there, pray with me with them. I'm going to pray by region. But let's go to the Lord in prayer right now. Father, we thank you and we praise you for the privilege and the opportunity we have to come before you tonight. Father, we come before you on behalf of these missionaries around the world. Father, in Africa. Father, we thank you for what you're doing in Africa. We thank you for moving. Pour out your spirit in Africa, Father. In Asia Pacific, Lord, those that are serving there. Lord, Father, I pray for your power to strengthen each and every missionary. Many of them are displaced right now, Lord. I pray that you'll work in their lives. Those in Eurasia, Lord God, Father, move in them and through them. It says in your word that the Spirit of the Lord dwelt over the earth. And Father, we pray that your power will strengthen these missionaries all over the earth.
Yes.
Those that are displaced right now that are home, they long to be there, but they can't. Father, I pray for you to strengthen and encourage and bless them.
Yes,
those that serve in Europe. Lord God, we thank you for them. We thank you for what you have done in them and through them.
Yes.
There are many that served you. They've given up their lives to go and serve for you, Lord God, and to bring people in your presence. It says in your word in Joel that we have never experienced anything like this before. And they were going into a plague. Father, we're in a plague now. And Father, I pray for these missionaries who've never experienced anything like this before. As we as pastors, we've never experienced anything like this. But your grace is sufficient to meet all our needs according to your riches and glory.
Yes,
those in Latin America and the Caribbean, Lord, move in their lives. Father, touch them, strengthen them, empower them with the Holy Spirit, Lord.
Yes.
Those in Northern Asia that have been affected in many ways that we can't imagine.
Oh, God.
Lord God, strengthen, let your Holy Spirit be their strength.
Yes.
Let your Holy Spirit be their guide. Be their power, Lord God. Give them a kiss today, Lord.
Oh, God.
Give them a kiss and give them your peace.
Yes.
Those internationals, the international ministries that serve around the world and here in the States.
Yeah.
We pray for the chaplains, the Chi Alpha, the U.S. missionaries. Lord, move in their lives,
yes.
I pray. By the power of the Holy Spirit, we're trusting in you during this time to refresh and to renew and to bless. And may the Lord bless you and keep you.
Yes.
May the Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious unto you.
Amen.
May
Amen.
The Lord turn his countenance to you and give you peace.
Amen.
By the power of the Holy Spirit.
Lord.
In Jesus' name,
thank
amen.
You, Jesus, thank you.
Amen.
Lord. Thank you, Jeff. At this time, Brian Cuck, our network assistant superintendent, is going to share a few thoughts.
Boy, as Jeff was praying for our missionaries around the world, I couldn't help but think, you know, it's not only around the world, but it's across the street. And this pandemic certainly has affected the whole world. And so I want to just talk to you for a moment about some outreach opportunities. You know, I know that every church, every community across Pennsylvania and Delaware is totally different. But, you know, these are difficult times, but man, what great opportunities. And we've seen here at GT, which I'm sure you've seen as well, a lot of opportunity to, you know, for unique viewers watching our services online, maybe people that would never walk in the doors of our church. But, you know, in these times, they're just checking out God and looking at maybe what hope there is in Jesus Christ. So you've seen that. I would really encourage you, man, let's be seeking God Pendel family on what's the unique outreach that we could do in our neighborhoods and our communities to make a difference. Because, you know, we need to care about everything, but we can't do everything. And so let's let the Spirit of God lead us for some unique ways that we can reach our communities. And so it's really powerful. You know, the one thing I would say is that the mission of your church, the mission of our church, the mission of our entire network, it's not put on hold. We're not on lockdown. It's certainly different, right? One of the values that we talk about here at GT is that our methods will change. And hardships like we're going through now, it kind of forces that change. But the change comes, but the message that we preach never changes. This is what Paul said to the Corinthians. He said, you know that God raised Jesus Christ from the dead. He's going to raise us with him. And what Paul goes on to say, that as we reach more and more people, God is going to receive more and more glory. So, man, that's our prayer for you. Thank you for what you're doing in your communities as we see this thing unfold and when we can get working back toward reentry. But until then, man, we're going to keep reaching people for the glory of God. So God bless you. Wherever you're worshiping tonight, man, we want to encourage you to stand. Josh is going to lead us back into the presence of God. So let's do it. Let's enter into worship with him.
Amen. We're believing God to awaken among us, to awaken his people tonight. And we're going to believe that the God of revival is going to come and pour out his blessings in your ministry, to pour out his blessings in your churches, as we believe for a harvest like never before, like an awakening like never before. So as we sing this song, would you agree with us? Would you join with us in believing for that refreshing, for that revival power to come among us? Amen. Come on, sing it with us.
God of wonders, your power has no end. The things you've done before, in greater measure, you will do again. Cause there's no prison wall you can't break through, no mountain you can move, all things are possible.
Yes, believe, God.
And there's no broken body you can raise, no soul that you can save, all things are possible.
Yes.
In the darkest night, you can light it up. You can light it up. Oh God of revival, let hope arise. Death is overcome. You've already won. Oh God of revival,
you rose in victory.
You rose in victory. And now you're seated forever on the throne.
So why should my heart fear?
So why should my heart fear? With you defeated, I will trust in you alone. Cause there's no prison wall you can't break through, no mountain you can move, oh, things are possible. There's no broken, and there's no broken body you can save, no soul that you can save. Oh, things are possible. In the darkest night, you can light it up. You can light it up. Oh God of revival, let hope arise. Death is overcome. You've already won. Oh God of revival. Oh God of revival. Lord, we need you. Come and breathe your life in us. Oh, revive us once again.
We sing, come awaken.
Come awaken your people. Come awaken the city. Oh God of revival, pour
yes,
it out. pouring
out. Come on, make that your prayer.
Every stronghold will crumble. I hear the chains hit the ground. Oh, God of revival, pour it, pour it out.
Come awaken your people. Come awaken this city. Oh, God of revival, pour it out, pour it out. Every stronghold will crumble. I hear the chains hit the ground. Oh, God of revival, pour it out.
We sing, come awaken.
Come awaken your people. Come awaken the city. Oh, God of revival, pour it out. Pour
every
out.
Stronghold, every stronghold will crumble.
I hear the chains hit the ground. Oh, God of revival, pour it out, pour it out.
In the darkest night, you can light it up.
You can light it up. Oh, God of revival, let hope arise. Death is overcome. You've already won. Oh, God of revival.
In the darkest night, you can light it up. You can light it up. Oh, God of revival, let hope arise. Death is overcome. You've already won. Oh, God of revival, oh, come and wake us up, Lord. You're the God of revival, the God of restoration.
Yes, Lord.
You refresh us.
Refresh us, God.
You restore us. Praise your name, we praise your name. Oh,
in a couple of moments, we're going to go to the Lord in prayer again, and we would love to pray for your needs in particular, so you can upload those on the Facebook chat there, and we'll pray for our needs when we come to the end here. But before we do that, we have a special segment here from our general superintendent. I am so thankful for the leadership that we have in the Assemblies of God, and Doug Clay has just been a rock and a great resource for us during this COVID crisis. And our general superintendent, Doug Clay, is going to come and he's going to bring us a word now.
Hi, Don. And all of the credentialed ministers of the Pendel District, sorry I can't be with you in person, but it is a delight to just greet you virtually. You know, no doubt these last few months have been incredibly stressful. People are becoming what I call COVID-19 fatigued, anxious, scared, and even on edge. But not all edginess can be contributed to COVID-19. Sometimes we develop high levels of fear and anxiety simply because we forget what the Lord said. You remember the time when Jesus and his disciples got into the boat and he was fully exhausted from a full day's worth of ministry? He says, let's go over to the other side. They start out, he falls asleep, a huge storm pops up, and the disciples go and wake up Jesus and they say to him, don't you even care that we're going to drown? You know, they got all wigged out because they forgot the words of Jesus. Jesus said, let's go to the other side of the lake. As we are coming out of COVID-19 and into a whole new set of unique realities that are probably prone to produce high levels of stress, I just want to encourage you. don't forget the words of the Lord. You know, it's easy to forget familiar scriptures like Jeremiah 29:11 that says, I know the plans I have for you, says the Lord, plans that are good and not for disaster, plans to give you a future and a hope. It's easy to forget the words of like Psalm 46, God is our refuge, God is our strength. He's an ever-present help in time of trouble. So I want to encourage you not to forget the words of the Lord. You know, with that in mind, would you take your tablet or your copy of God's Word and turn with me to Psalm 23? It's a familiar chapter of Scripture that I think provides some great reminders of what we can expect from God, even in days of uncertainty that are filled with stress. You know, we can expect God, first of all, to meet our needs. Psalm 23:1 says, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. Look, God will provide. It might look different than what we had in mind, but He'll provide. Secondly, we can expect Him to lead us to paths of peace where we can relax. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside quiet waters. Sometimes we just have to be taught and even forced to relax. Thirdly, we can expect God to replenish our strength. Wow, the first part of verse 3 of Psalm 23, He restores or refreshes my soul. Many today are still completely exhausted, running on fumes. Those of you who quickly adapted and brought your ministries online, you exhaustion is very, very real. That's a real feeling to you. But can I tell you, just as much as exhaustion is a real feeling to us, so is the strength and the refreshing that God will give us as we let Him. I see from Psalm 23 that we can expect God to guide us along right paths. He guides me along the right paths for His name's sake. You know, dealing with the virus or not being sure what to do is stressful, but you got to remember, God will guide you. Fifth, we can expect Him to walk with us when things do get worse. The psalmist says, even though I walk through the darkest valley, I'll not be afraid because you are close beside me. You know, for some, things might get worse before they get better, but I promise you, God will be close. I was reminded a few days ago when I was walking the grandchildren, we were going to cross a busy road and then go down to a walking trail that goes through some woods. And my four-year-old, who's still afraid to walk across the road, I said, Callum, just grab my hand. He looked at me and said, no, Papa, pick me up and carry me. Don't just hold my hand. And I noticed that when I picked him up, he clung really tight to me till we got across the road. Then we got down and he scurried away. You see, just holding his hand wasn't enough. He wanted to be extra close to me. I suspect that you would agree with me that our times of uncertainty and fearful times, God, the great shepherd, will be close to us. Sixth, we can expect Him to protect us when we feel vulnerable and insecure. Did you catch that in verse 4? Your rod and your staff protect and comfort me. When we're stressed and we're afraid, we feel vulnerable. We feel powerless, but God protects us. The psalmist also encourages us that we can expect God to show us divine favor. Verse 5 says, you prepare a banquet for me where all of my enemies can see. You welcome me as an honored guest and fill my cup to the brim. Can I tell you, your spiritual status doesn't make you immune to difficult times. But God will protect us in our times of vulnerableness, in our times of being stressed. The psalmist also says that we can expect God to be good to us no matter what. Verse 6 says, surely goodness and mercy or love will follow me all the days of my life. It may not feel like it, but I promise you, you can count on God's goodness and love to follow you. The psalmist also says that, you know what, we can expect to be with him in heaven someday. He says, surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of our lives. You know what? No matter what you experience on earth, I want you to remember the words of Jesus in John 14 when he says, don't let your hearts be troubled. If you believe in God, believe also in me. For in my Father's house are many mansions. And if it were not so, I would have told you that. I'm going to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I'll come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you will be also. Wow, what comforting words. So I pray during this focused time of refreshing that you'll simply remember the words of our Lord during these uncertain days, that he is a great shepherd and promises to be with you always.
Come on, let's sing these words together. He's so worthy. Worthy of every song we could ever sing. You're worthy of all the praise we could ever bring. You're worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Thank you, God. Come on, he's the name above every name. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only one who could ever save. You're worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you. Oh, we live for you. Come on, sing it with us. Holy and holy, there is no one like you. There is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder and show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me. So lead us in your love tonight. Open our eyes to see what you see, God. Build our life on you, the solid rock, the one we depend on. Jesus, Jesus. Come on, we build our foundation on him. Come on, sing it with me.
That I will build my life upon your love. It is a firm foundation. I will put my trust in you alone, and I will not be.
Come on, we declare those words tonight.
That I will build my life upon your love. It is a firm foundation, then I will put my trust in you alone, and I will not be shaken.
Yes, Lord, our firm foundation, God, the one we put our trust in, it's you alone. It's you alone, God, our solid rock. Build our lives on you. Build our lives on you. Come on, sing this, my hope.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but wholly lean on Jesus' name. And on Christ the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand.
Come on,
on, sing that again with me. On Christ, and on Christ the solid rock I stand, all other ground is sinking sand. All other ground is sinking sand. Yes, God, we lean into you. Our hope is built on nothing less. God, we trust in you alone. Come on, proclaim your faith in him today, church. God, I trust in you alone. When all around goes away, God, I build my faith. My firm foundation is set upon you, God. My firm foundation is built upon you tonight, God. When all around gives way, my trust is in you, God. The solid rock, the cornerstone. All else will fail, Lord. But I trust in you. But I trust in you. Thank you, God. And we're leaning, safe and secure from all alarms. Everlasting. Come on, lean into him tonight. We lean. Oh, leaning, leaning. We're safe and secure from all alarms. We're leaning, leaning, leaning on the everlasting. Arms leaning on the everlasting arms, leaning on the everlasting arms. Yes, Lord, we count on you. Our faith is in you. Like you, Lord. No one like you, Lord. Come on, I believe that word is for someone tonight. God, we can lean on you. We can trust in you. Lean into the everlasting arms of Christ. The arms of hope, the arms of peace. Safe and sound from all alarms. God, that's a word of hope we have today, God. We believe it. We believe it. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. Amen.
So we have been spending this time in the Lord's presence and receiving some ministry from the Word. You had talked earlier about your refreshment experience and this jar of blessing. And I gotta know, is my name in that jar?
Well, of course it is.
Of course it is.
Actually, I have a bigger jar for you. There's just so much. So much. Yes.
We're not even going to go down that trail. We're going to pray in just a moment. Pastors, ministers, ministers, spouses, those of you who are joining us, but I want to speak especially to our Pendel Ministry Network family. We love you guys. We appreciate you. We pray for you often, and you're on our hearts. You're in our minds, and we're just trusting God that he will get you, not only get you through this, that's survive, but that he gets you through this to thrive. That's our hope, and that's our prayer. Would you join us for a couple of moments as we just take one another's needs before the Father's throne? Father, in the name of Jesus, we pray for these needs that have come in over the internet. Lord God, we pray for Cheryl, and there's this pinched nerve numbness thing going on in her body. Lord, please touch her, heal her, we pray. We pray for Armando, God, and there's an international adoption going on. Would you please just kind of grease the wheels and let your will be done, but make this happen, we pray. Lord, we ask it in Jesus' name. There's another pastor who just needs peace and wisdom. Lord, we put that before you right now, and you know the situation and the context. Meet him, Lord, we pray.
Amen. And Lord, we see so many needs for cancers. Father, I pray that you would just rid these cancer cells, Father. Make every cell healthy. Lord Jesus, meet these people. Be their healer.
Yes, Lord.
Lord, we just claim this healing, Lord, and we just give that glory to you. Remove these tissues that don't belong.
Yeah.
We look for glorious testimonies. And Lord, we see needs for finances.
That's right.
Oh, so many at this time.
Dear God.
Lord, I pray that you break through, Father, the unemployment times and the lines and the issues. Lord, break through that. Lord, provide. Be the source.
Yes, Lord.
May we look back and hear the testimonies that where there was no income,
you were the source.
Lord, you met needs, Jesus. We will give you the glory, and
thank you,
Father, for being our provider.
And Lord, we pray for one of our fellow ministers who's also a counselor, and she needs poured into as she pours herself out. And so, Lord, I pray that you'll meet her in that area of need, Lord. One of our ministers also reminds us to pray for the bereaved. There are those who have lost loved ones because of this COVID crisis, Lord. Lord, I pray for the brother that I spoke with this afternoon who lost his mom. Lord, many. And I pray that, God, you will just fill in the gaps, fill in the holes, Lord, when somebody that we love, even though they're with you, they're not with us, and that's why we grieve. And so we pray, Lord, that you will help those that are going through a time of grief.
Well, thank you, Lord Jesus. We pray for those that are battling issues of substance abuse.
Yeah.
And Lord, during this time of isolation where they're separated from support networks, Lord, I know that you can be their support.
Yeah.
And Lord, that you can pull them from these issues, Lord, and raise them up. Mm-hmm. You will be their strength, Lord. Jesus, I just pray that you would be Lord over all those who have these needs.
Yeah, and Lord, Sherry reminds us to pray for youth and children. And Lord, they're going through a crisis too, and we can only imagine how this might impact them in the short, mid, and long term. God, help our ministers who minister to children and youth, Lord. We just put them before you tonight, and we ask that you would fill them up, refresh them, so that they have that which to refresh others with as well, Lord. In the name of Jesus, for our Chi Alpha groups, Lord, again, a time of displacement, be with them. Be with our leadership in Chi Alpha as well, Lord. Again, more missionaries and their needs, Lord, itineration needs. Oh God, meet their needs, we pray. Now, Father, we just commit our friends, our family to you and to your ongoing care. Love on them. Fill them with your Holy Spirit. I pray that, Lord, you'll help them not only to get through or survive, but help us to thrive. Make us healthy, Lord, so that we can speak to the health needs of others, both spiritual and emotional and physical and relational health needs, Lord. We pray these things. May your blessing flow in us and flow through us. We pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Josh.
Bless you and keep you. May
shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Over you tonight, that his favor would rest. Come on.
May his favor be upon you and the thousand generations and your family and your children.
Yes, God, let it be.
And their children.
Let it be, God.
Their children. Oh. May his favor be upon you
and
a thousand generations and your family and your children. Their children and their children.
May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations and your family and your children and their children and their children. May his favor be upon you and a thousand generations and your family and your children and your children. Come on, may his presence. May his presence go before you and behind
yes,
you
Lord.
And beside you, all around you and within you. He is with you. He is
come on in the morning,
you, in the morning, in the evening, in your coming, in your going,
in your weeping
and rejoicing. He is for you. 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 He is for you.
We sing amen.
And amen. Amen.
Amen.
And your family.
and their children, and their children, and their children. May His presence go before you, and behind you, and beside you, all around you, and within you. He is with you. Come on, in the morning, in the morning,
in the evening,
in your coming, in your going, in your weeping and rejoicing. He is for you, 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 He is for you. We've had together, church. Just so excited to be among the body of believers singing and praising. We pray that you truly have been refreshed tonight, and pray you go with the Lord's presence in all you do. We're looking forward to seeing you soon. Have a great night.